These D block elements, by reacting with oxygen, can produce oxides, are also called as oxoanions. Oxides are oxoanions. Once again, due to variable oxidation states of D block elements, when these D block elements heated with oxygen produces wide variety of oxides, the most of the oxides are having the general molecular formula MO. The oxidation states in general produced oxides of D block elements are plus 2. In addition to this type of oxides, some different types of oxides are also produced from D block element by reacting with oxygen. They are V2O5, vanadium 5 oxide. So this vanadium 5 oxide will show, or it will be called as amphoteric in character, amphoteric in nature. That means, in our previous sessions, we classified the oxides into three major categories. They are acidic oxides, basic oxides, and amphoteric oxides. Once again, what are acidic oxides? Those oxides, by reacting with water, if produces acids, such oxides are called as acidic oxides. Similarly, those oxides, by reacting with water, if produces bases as compounds, they are called as basic oxides. Similarly, the oxides which readily reacts with acids as well as bases are called as amphoteric oxides. Here, vanadium is a D block element, but when it reacted with oxygen to produce vanadium 5 oxide, the resulting vanadium 5 oxide will show amphoteric character. That means it reacts with acid as well as reacts with base or alkalis. So once again, some of the oxides are produced from this manganese dioxide, chromium trioxide, CrO, like this, which will be represented with the general molecular formula MO. This is not only this, iron is also available, which can produce FeO, ferrous oxide, Fe2O3, ferric oxide, etc. So all these are the different types of acids resulting from when 3D series of D block elements when heated in the presence of oxygen. Here, among these, some of the oxides are amphoteric in character, some of they are basic in character, some of they are acidic in character. Let us have CrO. While it is dissolved in water, it releases base. Hence, it is basic oxide. It is a basic oxide. Similarly, where we can consider Cr2O3 or CrO3 type of oxides, chromium trioxide can produce, when we are going to dissolve these acids in water, they releases acids as the products. Hence, they are called as acidic oxides. Acidic oxides. Now, in this oxides, the D block elements, especially in case of 3D series of elements, can exhibit various types of oxidation states. They starts with scandium 2, means scandium plus 3, plus 2, plus 4, in case of chromium, copper, manganese, etc., up to plus 7 oxidation states exhibited by D block elements in their oxide forms. Next one here. These oxides produced from D block elements and oxygen will show wide variety of chemical properties. So among all types of oxides, the most important oxides we are going to discuss here is K2Cr2O7, which will be considered as potassium dichromate, whereas KMnO4 we can consider it as potassium permanganate. The two types of important acids in our discussion, which are resulting by the reaction between D block elements, especially chromium present in potassium dichromate, manganese is the D block element or transition metal present in potassium permanganate. So let us have the detailed discussions regarding potassium dichromate followed by potassium permanganate. So let us write potassium. Potassium dichromate, which is having the molecular formula K2Cr2O7. So let us discuss the preparation and properties of this potassium dichromate. So once again, what is the transition metal present in potassium dichromate is chromium, and the oxidation state of chromium in potassium dichromate is, here each chromium results as the formation of +6 oxidation state. So let us have, potassium dichromate is an important chemical substances used in leather industry. It is an important chemical substance used in leather industry as well as in the preparation of dyes. Potassium dichromate is used as starting material. Here this potassium dichromate is produced from chromite ores. When chromite ores reacted with oxygen to produce, here the chromite ores reacted with oxygen and sodium or potassium carbonate. So it is a mild base. The reaction expected between chromite ores or iron ores or iron chromite ores when reacted with oxygen and sodium potassium carbonate to produce sodium or potassium chromate. So let us write the chemical equation for this FeCr2O4. This is the molecular formula of iron chromite. When this iron chromite reacted with sodium carbonate and oxygen, excess amount of oxygen, which may yields us the formation of Na2CrO4, so which will be considered as sodium chromate. Now the formed sodium chromate Na2CrO4 in the presence of acidic medium, that means when it reacted with concentrated sulfuric acid or diluted sulfuric acid, it may converts into NaCr2O7 plus the formation of H2O. Similarly, the formed sodium chromate, or we can consider sodium dichromate. So NaCr2O7 is going to react with potassium chloride solution to yield us K2Cr2O7. So we can write it as Na2Cr2O7 with this sodium dichromate. So when the formed sodium dichromate reacted with potassium chloride, aqueous potassium chloride, here the potassium is going to substitute sodium atoms of sodium dichromate and forms potassium dichromate as the ultimate product, 2NaCl. So this is the manner of preparation of potassium dichromate. Once again, it is the most important chemical substance used in leather industry as well as used as starting material for the preparation of various dyes. The chromite ores, during the preparation of potassium dichromate, the chromite ores reacted with sodium carbonate or potassium carbonate in the presence of excess amount of oxygen to produce sodium chromate. Now the formed sodium chromate will react with concentrated or diluted sulfuric acid to produce sodium dichromate. The resulting sodium dichromate, when treated with potassium, aqueous potassium chloride, then the sodium atoms of sodium dichromate are substituted with potassium dichromate. Hence the resulting compound is potassium dichromate with the general molecular formula K2CR2O7.